Hey, listen, oh, you see that red subscribe button over there? Nothing, just hit it. And this bell icon, ring that bell to know every time I come online. Give me a like, 'cause it's free. Using Kralon Supra palette, this is one of my favorite palettes. Using shades FS28 and FS29 for skin, and these are the two contour shades, 22 and 24. As you can see, I've mixed them and applied, and now let's blend it all in. Anybody who has any trouble blending knows the value of spritzing a little bit of face mist on your face and on the sponge. It just gives a little bit of that slip, a little bit of lubrication, so your skin doesn't have to take so much of beating. I'm just going to pat and press. I'm using this soft rose sponge, velvet sponge by the brand Juno & Co. It'll be the best tool to apply Kralon foundations with, because Kralon foundation is a wax based foundation, and if I use any other sponge, water in that sponge, it doesn't really help me blend the wax in this foundation very well. So either it works well with a buffing brush or it works well with this sponge. Because it has small microfibers on it, I mean, it's called velvet sponge for a reason. So you can use it in a circular motion, it'll do the job of a buffing brush. You can use it in dragging and tapping motion where it's going to give you a lot of coverage. So I love this sponge for getting more coverage out of my foundation. Just patting, pressing, dragging, those are the motions that I'm mostly gonna be applying it. And wherever I feel like I need more blend, I'm just going to go in circularly like that. It has a nice pointy tip, so I can just like pat and blend underneath the eyes. FS28, guys, has some yellow in it, so it works really well as a concealer. And FS29 has a little bit of pink in it, so it works really well for your cheeks. I like to mix these two shades. When I'm blending my contour, notice how I'm blending it upward. This is very important, guys. You have to blend it upward so that everything looks youthful and perky, you know, so that our contour doesn't look like it's coming down. You don't want the shadows, you don't want your skin to look saggy. Blend everything in, give it some final finishing touches, blend that concealer a little bit more. Gonna take a big long stripple brush, a brush with long fibers, and I'm gonna brush everything together, like just blend, mesh everything together, and set it with powder. Take that powder and apply it in a V form, like so. This is where you would apply a lighter shade if you want your neck to look plumper. Alia's neck is much plumper than mine, and if you want it to look slimmer, that is where you would contour. Like, now we're gonna take some bronzer and we're just going to place it in a Brontor placement. Because she's got the most beautifully bronze skin. I'm placing it in a 3 shape, like a Victoria's Secret model kind of a shape. This is just gonna add some subtle glow to our skin. When we've applied so much of skin, it's important to just add a little bit of warmth to the skin. Especially when we wanna do this Alia's look justice, because she's got the most beautifully bronzed cheeks. I'm gonna take this big brush and I'm gonna take some bronzer and just lightly draw a 3 shape, and then we are going to buff it all in together, like just make it look like a blush come bronzer come contour. It's important for us to like add a little bit of contour shade underneath the jawline. Using a slightly grayer shade to do this. We don't want to contour with our bronzer. And let's get to highlighting.
I is wearing pretty matte skin. Now, we can't recreate the studio lights, the professional lights, that even though she's wearing a matte skin, even then, there is kind of a subtle glow onto her cheeks. We can't fully replicate that because we don't have the equipment for it. But what we can do is put highlighter. Now, she's not wearing any highlighter though. I'm gonna go in with, this is a Max Factor eyeshadow. These are their Wild Pots collection. This is the in the shade Pale Pebble. This is, this eyeshadow just is the most smoothest. You see that? That's all it is. No shimmer, no glitter. Just something very smooth. And that's how her skin is looking over here. Very smooth. Just because of the lights. She herself is not wearing any highlighter, but we are going to. This is a very good matte highlighter. Like, if you guys want to wear a highlighter in a conservative setting, this would be it. The only thing is, this highlighter is a little chalky, and because of that, the beauty of it comes alive once you sort of spritz some face mist on it. Alia is wearing the most beautiful peachy, nudie, pinky color. It's not like a complete cool pink, neither is it a complete peachy pink. So I'm going to have to mix two different shades to get the color that she's wearing.
I'm gonna be mixing two colors. This is in the shade Rose by Studio West Lip Liner, and this is in the shade Rosewood by Max Factor Elixir Collection. You can see how one is slightly pinkier and the other is slightly peachier. And that's because Alia wears the most beautiful pinky, peachy, nudie kind of a lip color. I could not make out what is it that she's exactly wearing because the color is looking different in different scenes. That might have something to do with the lighting. Like the scenes where she's outdoor, it's looking more peachy. That might have something to do with the sunlight, because sunlight can make everything look a little warmer than what it is. And when it comes to the indoor, when she's dancing in that huge hall, her lipstick is looking like a little bit more pinkier, and that might have something to do with the artificial light. And in order to sort of get close to that, I am mixing these two shades. And I'm quite pleased with the way it turned out. I wish I had mixed this before. I think I'm gonna wear this quite a lot now, because this shade, it's beautiful, it's nude, but it's not too nude. It's not nude to a point where it would like wash me off. It's just that little bit of cute, pinky, peachy, nudie color. So overall, I like it. And I hope I had done justice to the look that I was trying to achieve, to Alia's look in the song. As you can see, I'm pretty pleased with my mixing. We're gonna take those colors on our hand, like so. I'm just gonna make the concoction on my hand so that I can apply it on my cheeks, because that way it looks so much more prettier, you know, as opposed to going in with a powder blush. I really like to use a cream lipstick on my cheeks, because it looks, you know, your cheeks look much more, according to me, they look nice when they are a little bit more of creamy texture as opposed to flat matte. I mean, different variations suit different bone structures, but over here I'm trying to make my cheeks look a little plumpier, like Alia's cheeks. So I think the creamy texture would serve that purpose here. Also, it just like looks more cohesive that way if you just use the same lip color on your cheeks. I felt like I could use a little bit more of blending underneath my eyes, because by this point my eyes had started creasing, because I am going to apply another layer. This is Maybelline Age Rewind. I'm just going to do a little bit of highlighting, because Alia's underneath the under eyes, they're not highlighted by makeup, but they are highlighted by the lighting. Like, the studio lights are so beautiful that they are making her cheekbones look forward. They are making her contour look as if, you know, it's a little deeper, even though she's not wearing a contour, she's only wearing a bronzer. I quite like this concealer for highlighting purposes, and I'm gonna apply it like so. I'm using a concealer brush by EcoTools. We're gonna apply it and leave it on for like few seconds, just for it to melt and mesh with our skin. And on top of that, I'm going to blend. I know I've applied powder and then I'm applying it, but guys, this concealer, it holds very well on top of powder too. The only thing is you can't move it. So a little bit of highlighting on the center of the forehead, in the center of the nose, on the Cupid's bow, a little bit on the chin. As you can see, I've just made that cute little YouTube tree on my nose and the forehead. I'm taking this, because this is a highlighting concealer, I'm going to use it to clean up that smoky look that we have done. You know, just to make our eyes look a little bit more pulled up and a little bit more feline. Bringing the concealer down on either sides of the nose to make your nose look a little bit more slimmer. Because Alia is not contoured her nose in this, but her nose is looking contoured again because of the lighting. I'm doing my best here, guys, to imitate the studio lights. I'm taking this flat brush. This is a flat brush by Faber-Castell, and that's a company that makes painting brushes. Don't worry, I've washed it before I use it on my face. Many times I find using painting brushes for makeup work really well, but that might just be me. I mean, my hands are more used to painting brushes. Taking that highlighting concealer outward. I don't know why I squint my eyes every time I do this. It's important for us to like hit the inner corners, because you know, when you've smokied your eyes, you've really brought in so much of darkness that it's important to like add some light to like just, you know, bring everything back into proportion, just so that it looks like the light is hitting you at all the right points. With a sponge, this is by the brand called Georgia, and this is local to India. It's a quite affordable and a very good sponge, and just using that to buff everything in and blend everything in. Notice how I've gone into a sponge this time, not using the velvet sponge. We only use velvet sponge for like the first layer because it has that microfiber in it. It can give you that buffing brush kind of a finish if you use it circularly. It can also disturb the layers if you use it at this stage. So we're just using a smooth sponge for this purpose. I'm gonna go in with this lip liner. This is something a makeup artist does on me. When he wants to like put a bindi and he doesn't have the right shade of red bindi, he does this. He uses a lip liner pencil to do that. So that's how the look looks with the bindi. And gonna pop on some lashes and be right back.
So that's the finished look, guys. I hope you enjoyed watching the video and I hope you guys learned something from it. There were a lot of tips and tricks regarding the skincare, about the prep. And once you remove the makeup, if you feel like your pimples have gotten a little irritated, or your spots or heat boils have gotten a little irritated with the makeup you have worn, you can again spritz some rice water on it, because rice water is a natural exfoliant and it's also very cooling. You can also put some neosprin on it again, because neosprin helps with the healing process and it also provides a layer for that skin so that the bacteria doesn't eat it. I mean, this is just something I do on days when I have to shoot with something on, and then once you put makeup on it, it only makes it worse, and then you have to shoot again the next day. So neosprin is really my lifesaver in those cases. I really, really love this look, guys. I feel like it's very pretty. It's very glamorous without meaning to be. Thank you so much for watching. If you guys like what I do here, please subscribe to my channel. I'm really new at YouTube. I'm just starting off and I'm looking to upgrade my tech. So if you could hit the like button and if you could subscribe, it would really help me a lot. I hope all of you are having a wonderful time, whatever it is that you're up to. I hope you guys have an amazing day ahead. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.